Welcome to the Daily Reminder Network. Heart Softeners by Sheikh Mu'izz Bukhari.
My dear respected elders, brothers and sisters, and the viewers of the Daily Reminder Network, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد بن عبد الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم أما بعد. As always, we begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher, protector, and curer. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower His choicest of blessings and salutations upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions, and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. Inshallah ta'ala, for tonight's heart softener, we will be touching on al-hasad wal-ayn. We will be touching on jealousy and evil eye. Allahu Akbar. Jealousy is one of the most destructive emotions an individual's heart can harbor. It is one of the most self-destructive emotions too. Ibn Manzoor, the North African lexicographer, he mentions in his famous dictionary, Lisanul Arab, the tongue of the Arabs, that the definition of al-hasad is that to wish that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala plucks away, or to wish that a blessing that Allah the Almighty has blessed upon an individual be snatched away from that individual. Allahu Akbar. May Allah save us all. Hasad, jealousy, is an emotion that makes an individual feel evil towards others. And it also makes an individual wish evil for others. And it also makes an individual happy when some misfortune befalls others, or the people, or the one that he envied. Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, and the hadith is in Ibn Majah, Iyyakum wal hasad. The narration goes along the lines of these words. Iyyakum wal hasad. Beware of jealousy. Al-hasadu ya'kulu al-hasanat kama ta'kulu an-naru al-hatab. Allahu Akbar. Jealousy destroys your good deeds just as how a fire gobbles up firewood. Allahu Akbar. Just as how a fire gobbles up firewood, jealousy destroys your good deeds. Jealousy makes a person's heart go dark. It makes a person's heart become evil. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. Some of the factors that grow jealousy in an individual's heart are anger, malice. Because the minute you feel anger towards an individual, the minute you feel hatred towards an individual, you start envying that individual. You start envying the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed that individual. And also from the factors that grow jealousy is that when an individual has pride, Allah save us all. When an individual has pride, arrogance, and also when he has love for name and fame, when he has love for publicity, when he has love for the limelight, when he has love for stardom, when he has love for fame, then he starts envying another person growing, another person trying to become similar to him. This is also one of the causes of jealousy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. And also another factor that grows jealousy is the natural or the evil nature of an individual. May Allah save us all from such a nature. Some people are naturally born with that jealousy, and they need to work a lot on their hearts to free themselves from that evil quality. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. Now there are three types of jealousy. Number one is that an individual wishes, or he wishes that the person who is envying, that blessing that he is envying should be plucked away from that individual, and no one should have that blessing. That's one type of jealousy, which is very bad. The second type of jealousy is that he wishes that that blessing be plucked away from that individual and he gets the blessing. Say, for example, a person is wealthy, a person is famous. He wishes that that fame be plucked away from him so that he gets that fame, so that he gets that attention. Or that that wealth be plucked away from him so that he gets that wealth. That is also an evil type of jealousy. The final type of jealousy is where an individual wishes for a blessing, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed an individual, but he does not wish that it be plucked away from that individual. And this is known as ghibta, and this is a permissible type of jealousy, where he wishes for the same blessing. Say, for example, he wishes for the same wealth to do good, but he does not wish that the wealth be plucked away from the person he looks at with jealousy. This is a permissible type of jealousy. Now, moving on to the next evil thing that jealousy often brings about, and that is al-ayn, Allahu Akbar. That is evil eye. Let me share with you all a narration. A narration that has been recorded in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad. And it has been classed sahih by Imam Al-Albani, rahimahullah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once set out on a journey. The narration goes along the lines of these words. He set out on a journey with a few of his sahaba, ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. They had to pass by a mountain valley. And there was a sahabi by the name Sahal ibn Hunayf, radiyallahu anhu. When they made camp by that valley, he had to take a bath, and he went to a place and started taking a bath. He started bathing. So he had to expose his upper body to take a bath. Then there was another Sahabi radiallahu anhu. His name was Amir ibn Rabi'ah. The minute he saw Sahal ibn Hunayf taking a bath, and he saw the complexion of Sahal ibn Hunayf, he immediately uttered a statement. He said, "What a beautiful complexion you have got." Or, "What beautiful skin, what blemish-free skin that you have got." The minute he uttered that statement, the Sahabi who was bathing, Sahal ibn Hunayf radiallahu anhu, immediately fell down to the ground. Allahu Akbar. News immediately goes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asks as to what happened just before he fell down, for him to fall down like that. Then they informed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of the statement of Amir ibn Rabi'ah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very sternly asks, "Why are you trying to kill your own brother?" Allahu Akbar. If you see something that you like in your brother, praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and pray that Allah blesses him. Say mashaAllah, say barakallah, say tabarakallah, say Allahumma barik fi. Pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses him in that blessing of his. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam immediately instructed that the person who cast the evil eye, Amir ibn Rabi'ah, that he should take a bath, and that the water that drips from his body should be collected, and that water should be poured on the individual upon whom the evil eye was cast upon, Sahal ibn Hunayf. The minute that water was poured over his head and over his body, he got up as if nothing had ever afflicted him. Allahu Akbar. Scholars say this is one of the treatments, and that is if you know who the person is who cast evil eye upon you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from this evil of evil eye. Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he states that evil eye is like a poisonous arrow. A poisonous arrow that is shot from an individual's heart through his eyes. And the minute he casts evil eye, at times it misses the target, at times it hits the target. And if it hits the target, that person is going to be afflicted. And at times it misses the target if that person has recited his daily awrad, if he has taken precaution, if he has recited the shares of the Quran that he's supposed to recite, and if he has sought refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then that arrow might miss him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, and the hadith is in Muslim, al-aynu haqqun, that evil eye is true. Al-aynu haqqun. Because some people deny or some people negate it. They say it's folklore, it's old wives' tales. You know, we can't believe evil eye. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam states, and the hadith is in Muslim, al-aynu haqqun, that evil eye is true. And if there was anything to overtake the divine decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that would-be evil eye. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went on to say along the lines of these words, that if someone were to come to you and ask you to bathe and give the water, then you are supposed to do. Just in case someone thinks that you are the person who cast evil eye, and if he came to you and asks you, if he comes to you and asks you to bathe and give him the water, you are supposed to comply and you are supposed to bathe and give the water. Because at times, without us even knowing, we cast evil eye. So it is always upon us to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let it be a nice house. Let it be a good motor vehicle. Let it be beauty, complexion, wealth. Let it be a good voice. Let it be anything. Let it be a talent. Let it be anything you see in a person that you are pleased with, that you like. Immediately remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should bless that individual and not cast evil eye, and also not harbor any evil feelings such as jealousy, envy or hatred upon that person. Let me mention an anecdote from the lives of our Salafun al-Salih. And this is a story about Sulaiman ibn Abdul Malik. He was a khalifa, he was a caliph, and one fine day he was a very young person. Who was the caliph. So one day he went, just to show you all the seriousness of evil eye, one day he went in front of the mirror and he started admiring himself. He started admiring himself and he looked at the mirror and said, "You know, Sulaiman, look at how young you are. Look at how young you are, and you are the caliph. Allahu Akbar." He looked at the mirror and started admiring himself. The people around him stated that it was not even 1 month since he did that and he suddenly passed away. Scholars mentioned that it could be the cause behind his death could be evil eye, and wallahu alam, Allah knows best. Urwa ibn Zubayr, he once dresses up his son really well. His son, he dresses him up really well and takes him to the king's palace, the caliph's house. He goes up, and the caliph at that time was Walid ibn Abd al-Malik. The minute he saw this young boy dressed up so well, he said, "What a beautiful young boy. What a beautiful dress that you have dressed and come today." And then he states that it was not even a few moments. They went to the stable where the horses were all tied up. Suddenly a horse reared up and kicked that young boy, breaking his neck, snapping his neck in seconds. Allahu Akbar. Our Salafun al-Salih, they reported to have said, that even when you have young children, especially the sisters, the mothers, they should be careful that when they look at their own children, that they don't cast evil eye upon their children. And our Salafun al-Salih, they reported to have said, at times it is even appropriate for you to shave the heads of your children so that they don't look too beautiful, that people may cast their evil eye. And if you have a fear or an apprehension that this individual may cast an evil eye upon my child, or this group of people may cast evil eye upon my child, then it is upon you not to beautify your child too much so that they may cast evil eye. Allahu Akbar. So we need to be careful that we do not cast evil eye upon ourselves. When we look at the mirror, we recite the sunnah and the dua that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us to recite. Let us not admire ourselves too much, and let us not cast evil eye upon our own children. And most important of all, let us not harbor envy towards others. Allahu Akbar. Let us not be afflicted by evil eye, nor should we cast evil eye upon anybody. Let us purify our hearts. Let us cleanse our hearts from the evil of jealousy, from the evil of hatred, from the evil of envy. And let us stay away from casting evil eye upon others. Because the more we purify our hearts, the more we will stop envying others. The more we will stop desiring the things of others, the possessions of others, the talents of others. And the more we become humble in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the lesser we would desire name and fame, the lesser we would desire publicity, and the lesser we would desire the limelight and stardom. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins, and may He cleanse our hearts from envy, from hatred, from jealousy, and may He save us from becoming targets of evil eye. And likewise, may He, the Almighty, save us from casting evil eye upon others, and may He unite us in the gardens of Jannah, just as how He united us here tonight with our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa akhir da'waya anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Jazakumullahu khair.
Donate now. Go to www.thedailyreminder.org/donate and stay updated by joining our network's social links.